Have you ever experienced pain in the hands or toes? Have you ever woke up and you could not use your hands as they were very swollen and painful? Not only that you have joint pain, but do you ever wake up with severe dry eyes? Or do you need to drink water all the time? Are these signs of arthritis? Is this rheumatoid arthritis or Sjogren's disease? In this video, I will explain to you the signs and symptoms of two of the most common autoimmune diseases that I see in my clinic, Rheumatologist OnCall, rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease. And I will also answer you the most common questions that my patients and people in this YouTube community will ask me. How are they similar? How are they different? Can they exist together? Yes. These two diseases, rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease, can very well come together. Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Both rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease are autoimmune diseases that can happen independently of each other, or they can come together. Because many patients will have signs and symptoms of both, I will answer the most common questions I get from patients and from many people from my YouTube community. What are the most common signs of rheumatoid arthritis? In most patients, rheumatoid arthritis starts in the small joints of the hands or feet, but there is a specific pattern: the small and big knuckles, sometimes the thumbs and the wrist. You may experience pain, swelling and stiffness in both hands, both feet at the same time. Most patients will have difficulty using their hands or walking out of the bed, getting out of the bed in the morning. The morning stiffness is prolonged, usually more than 1 hour, but it will improve with movement. Other joints can be also affected, like the wrist, the shoulders, the knees, hips, and even ankles. The joints are visibly swollen most of the time. Plus, rheumatoid arthritis patients also complain of symptoms like low-grade fever, dry eyes, dry mouth, and muscle pain. If rheumatoid arthritis is not treated, it will eventually lead to joint deformities and disability. How is rheumatoid arthritis diagnosed? The diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis is a combination of clinical signs like joint pain and specialized blood tests such as rheumatoid factor, anti-CCP antibodies, elevated markers of inflammation like sedimentation rate or C-reactive protein. Some patients might have a positive NA, but very rarely patients will have other types of antibodies like positive SSA and SSB antibodies, as we see in patients with Sjogren's disease. Then, x-rays or an MRI can show erosions or other signs of inflammation in the joints. Now, let's shift the gear and understand Sjogren's disease. Sjogren's disease is a very complex autoimmune disease that can come alone. We call this primary Sjogren's disease, or it may come in combination with other autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, autoimmune thyroiditis, inflammatory myopathy, or autoimmune diseases of the liver like primary biliary cirrhosis. Primary Sjogren's disease can cause many symptoms, from severe dry eyes to dry mouth, to joint pain, muscle pain, fatigue, fibromyalgia, lung disease, and neurological symptoms. It may affect the brain, or it may cause tingling and numbness in your legs. If you want to learn more, watch my other videos in my YouTube channel, as I have explained a lot about this disease. How is Sjogren's disease affecting the joints? 50% of patients with Sjogren's disease complain about joint and muscle pain. The pain in the joints is called arthralgia. The pain in the muscle is called myalgia. Sjogren's disease, like rheumatoid arthritis, can cause joint pain that is symmetric, can come and go, but unlike rheumatoid arthritis, does not cause joint deformities. The most common affected joints are still the hands, the wrists, and the knees. Patients do not see much visible swelling in their hands. The pain and the morning stiffness can also be prolonged, usually for hours or even the whole day. How to diagnose Sjogren's disease? Patients with Sjogren's disease must meet certain criteria, from clear evidence of dry eyes and dry mouth to certain blood tests or even a lip biopsy. The most common blood tests ordered are ANA or anti-nuclear antibody test, SSA and SSB antibodies, rheumatoid factor, complement levels, and markers of inflammation like sedimentation rate and C-reactive protein. And we also order other blood tests like your liver panel, your kidney panel, and sometimes the serum electrophoresis. Now, this is important. Rheumatoid factor can be found in 40% of patients with Sjogren's disease, and it is more common in people with joint disease. About 10% of people with Sjogren's disease have anti-CCP antibodies, but at this point, we don't know if the patient has rheumatoid arthritis or Sjogren's disease, because many of the patients are initially diagnosed with Sjogren and then they can develop rheumatoid arthritis. Now, let's summarize what we have discussed and understand the critical differences between rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease and understand their similarities. What are the similarities between rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease? Both rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease affect small and medium joints, like the hands, the wrists, the knees, and muscles, and they can cause dry eyes and dry mouth. Both can affect the lungs and can even cause fibrosis, translating into difficulties to breathe. The dryness in the eyes is very bothersome and sometimes can lead to visual changes. The dryness of the mouth can also lead to gum disease because the lack of saliva will permit the bacteria in the mouth to proliferate and lead to periodontal disease and sometimes losing the teeth. Both of these diseases can cause fatigue and fibromyalgia. And both of them can have a positive rheumatoid factor, sometimes positive CCP antibodies, but usually Sjogren's disease have positive NA, positive SSA, positive SSB antibodies, which are rare in patients with rheumatoid arthritis. Now, in terms of treatment, we treat them similarly, depending on the severity of the symptoms. If Sjogren's disease is more aggressive, then we use more aggressive medication. What are the differences between rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren's disease? Untreated rheumatoid arthritis leads to joint deformities, while Sjogren's disease can cause pain, but it doesn't cause joint deformities. Rheumatoid arthritis can cause erosions to the joints, while Sjogren's disease does not usually react in that way. Sjogren's disease is much milder to your joints, but can continue to be bothersome for many other parts of the body, from your eyes to the mouth to the nerves and to even the lungs. How to find help for rheumatoid arthritis or Sjogren's disease when you need it the most? As you probably experienced, being in pain due to rheumatoid arthritis or Sjogren's disease is unpleasant. It may take months to see a specialist, a rheumatologist trained to diagnose and treat those diseases. That means that for many months, you will wait in pain and anxiety. And this is something that I consider unacceptable. That is why I started my company, Rheumatologist OnCall, to help people in pain when they need it the most. My company can see patients in multiple US states. We also see patients worldwide who will need our help to sort out the diagnosis. We help people from the comfort of their homes. No need to travel or waiting in a waiting room for hours. Not only that, but we do not discriminate based on your insurance. We do not delay your care, and we offer you truly affordable pricing and transparency of all costs. We are here to help people when they need it the most, not in 6 months. If you need our help, do not hesitate to contact us. If you know someone struggling to see a rheumatologist or need a rheumatologist that will take excellent medical care, check our website and schedule a consultation. Thank you for joining me today. If you have any comments, please don't forget to leave them in the bottom of this video. Thank you for joining me today, and I will see you soon.
Rheumatologistoncall.com